everybody. Welcome in once again to another edition of Inside the Lion's Den as we head on to the volleyball court this time around, as I'm joined by this week's South Atlantic Conference Defensive Player of the Week, and that is freshman Kayla McDuffie. And Kayla, thanks so much for joining us here this morning.
Glad to be here.
Absolutely. Well, I just said it, honored this week as the Defensive Player of the Week. And, you know, you guys have been a lot of fun to watch. And we've mentioned that many times across the Queen Sports Network as we've watched you. But across the three matches last week, you had 18 total blocks on the week, including 7 assists in that 3-0 win over Mars Hill. You know, you're averaged about a block and a half per set. Let me ask you this. Let's start with this. And, you know, I talked to Coach early in the season, and, you know, she had said that it was someone like you that was going to have to step up. Of course, Lindsay Elmore, a great middle blocker, but I think it's one of those positions in volleyball that might be overlooked a little bit. And so, you know, what made you want to choose that position? And of course, you know, what kind of mentality does it take to be a middle blocker?
So the way I picked the position was basically I was like a little bit taller than like normal, you know, what the my girls on my team were. So, excuse me, I was like put in the middle. I would say the mentality to like be a middle blocker is like, it's just hard work, you know, going back and forth for the blocks, transitioning off the net, you know, trying to get your approach in and stuff like that.
Absolutely. And, you know, again, you're currently ranked 4th in the conference for blocks per set, but you're actually ranked number 1 in total blocks. And I know, you know, that's not something you go into the season saying, hey, yeah, I'm going to be ranked number 1 in the conference. Yeah. But, you know, as a freshman, that's got to give you a little bit of confidence that you're doing something right.
Yeah. I really like blocking. It's one of the main things that I don't know. That's really just hyped me up. Like, you can't hit the ball through me and over me. So that's what I really enjoy about the game.
Well, again, you are the first and sometimes last line of defense against that net. And of course, you know, you guys are doing very well this year. You guys have 11 wins on your freshman season here. Still a long time left to be played here this season. But that being said, you know, what's the state of the team right now? And what's your guys' mentality as you guys head into this next week?
So we, you know, set goals as a team. So, you know, we're just trying to host, you know, the conference, the SAC conference tournament, stuff like that. So we're just, you know, working together, staying mentally focused to like prepare for like the rest of our games for the rest of the season.
Well, you know, I've talked to Brooke Farley. I've talked to Coach Long about that first month of the season. And, you know, I got the coach and the seniors perspective, but as a freshman to be on the road that much, you know, what did it mean to have that time to build the chemistry with your teammates?
It just took a lot of time just like playing each game. We know we just learned something new about each other and we just played well together as like each time we were on the road. So, yeah.
Well, you know, and you have a unique perspective as well because you come here with one of your high school teammates and Allie Johnson. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I got to ask, what was the ultimate decision on choosing Queens?
I would say I really liked the campus. Like, it was in Charlotte, you know, like city life, you know, I really liked that. But like the campus was really nice. And then just like coming here to play volleyball is like a dream come true, just like playing college sports. So, you know, it's taking any, you know, option I could get.
Well, you know, talk a little bit about Allie and, you know, your guys' chemistry as teammates in high school. And how have you seen that sort of develop even more now? Have you guys have both taken that step to the next level?
You know, we're on the court together, like when we'll play beside each other. So just like hyping each other up, you know, as one of us gets the point. And I would say like our bond has like gotten like stronger and closer, but like also like since we play together, I know how she plays, she knows how I play. So, you know, stuff like that.
Sure. Absolutely. It's always nice to have, especially when you take that next leap to the next level of having a little bit of familiarity to go along with it. Right. Well, you know, let me ask you this. In terms of heading into these next couple of matches, of course, a big one against Anderson on Thursday, another big one coming up on Saturday. I mean, really, from this point on, every match is bigger than the last, of course, as you guys are trying to jockey for position conference play-wise. You know, what is the mentality that you go in and attack every single match with? Does it change every match, or is it kind of a constant that you just keep reminding yourself?
It's a constant. I keep reminding myself, like, staying focused, you know, wanting to get my swing in, you know, wanting to get the block, you know, stuff like that. Just, like, working for each point so we can reach, like, 25.
Sure. Absolutely. And let me – final question I got to ask you is, you know, what drew you to the sport of volleyball, and why is this the sport that you chose to continue your career with?
I would say I picked this sport. I just like really loved the game. You know, sure. Each time I've like done like travel volleyball with my teams, I've just loved each team I've had. So that just made me want to like continue playing. So I think that's the reason, just like the family and like the friends that you can like make while playing the sport.
Sure. Absolutely. And, you know, you guys came in with a very young class, of course, mm-hmm. this year, and as an overall team, fairly young, but, you know, have you guys used that as saying, hey, we might be young, but we're talented. And how do you translate that onto the court?
Yeah, we talk about it a lot. You know, there is like more freshmen. So we just like try to stay focused and like not really try to say that like we're a freshman team, but we sure. are. So we just try to like have the mentality of like, yeah, we may have like less experience, but we are talented enough to like compete with the other teams.
Absolutely. And trust me, coach definitely echoed that when I talked to her last week. She said, you know, we don't like to say that we're a young team because we have the talent, and so we should play accordingly. So, congratulations again on getting your first Defensive Player of the Week nomination for the South Atlantic Conference. I promise you, if you're judging by what I've seen, it's not going to be the last. But
Thank you.
Congratulations on that. And, of course, best of luck going into this weekend as well. Mm-hmm. We'll be alongside you, and I really appreciate you joining us here this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. All right, for Kayla McDuffie, I'm Mike Lennon. Go out and enjoy the rest of your day, everybody. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button down there at the bottom. Follow us across social media at Queens Athletics. That way you can get all the freshest content right here from the Queens Sports Network. For Kayla McDuffie, I'm Mike Lennon. Enjoy the rest of your day. And as always, go Royals.